Hi, I am going to explain how to process two-dimensional homonuclear NMR data by using the Topspin software. So in the newer version of the Topspin, just you drag and drop, so it will do Fourier transformation automatically. Otherwise, you have to give a command like x sub d, like Fourier transformation for both dimension f1 and f2 dimensions, it will do for x sub b. Otherwise, except 1 or FT1 or except 2 or FT2, it will do Fourier transformation, means time domain data to frequency domain. It will convert. Another thing is, when you open the spectra, the phase is too bad because it is out of the phase. So we have to do phase correction and the baseline corrections. In this video, I am going to explain you how to do phase correction, baseline correction, and peak picking integration, and how to extract this image as a PDF and image, and how to use this for publications. So here, in the Topspin, go to the process, and here adjust phase and calibration is there. Peak picking integration option is there. So what I will do, just adjust phase. And you select some peaks, just you select and drag. Then I will select one peak here and another peak here, and you can make all. Then this one is for row, so you can do the phase correction on rows or you can do phase correction on columns. You select column, actually this is fine for me. You only select rows. So what I will do the 0th order phase correction and first order phase correction. So 0th order phase correction I am doing, and this one is save and go back, and this one is without saving you can return. So I will do save and go back. So actually you can see that, so there is a red color. So what I will do, I will go to here and I will tilt 180 degree. Now we will get positive, it was a negative, then go back. Now you have spectra, nice spectra, and do ABS 1 for baseline correction as second axis and ABS 1 for baseline correction for first axis. And another thing, actually the peak shape sometimes you will get, because if you give a number of levels, means this is a this is the 2D contour, this is also proton, this side also proton. So this contour, how many slices you made, depends on that you will get a proper shape. So for that, what you have to do, just I will select this, I will expand one peak, and give command n lev. So this is 6, actually it is showing 6, except p, or you can change here also 1.864. okay, so if you want to make more number of slices, give here n lev, so you can give 64, and lev calculate means number levels calculate, so increase the number of levels. You can cut that. Okay, so after this, another thing you can do by here and edit, go to the right click and edit contour levels. So here you can take positive, negative. If you have a rosy spectra, you need a positive, negative. If you have only positive spectra, then you can select only positive, because here negative value is there. So then here in level increment, you can give 1.3 increment, and you can give 32 or 64, anything you want, just fill, now it will be, and apply. So it will remove that negative points from the spectra, only you will get only positive. And another thing is, here you, this projection is from a 2D projection, because of less number of TD points, the spectra will be broadened. So what I will do, I will add this 1D projection. So, you can delete the integrations here for the time being. So here I have a well resolved means splittings, and here actually in the 2D I can't get proper splitting because of the less number of 3D points. So I want to add this 1D spectra as external projection to this 2D. So if I give a plot directly, I can't get projections here. So for that, what you have to do, view proj command means projection, and now it's a row and 999 processing, and I will give OK, and again proj command you did for row, and now you have to do for column. Then you saved this one as another number, another processing number, and OK. So after this, right click here and add external projection. So right click external projection, and we add, you can add that third one. Third is 1D, I'm going to add third, and here also external projection. Here also I will give third number 1D, because here I have a third number 1D. Okay, after this I have to calibrate this one. So because before that we have to calibrate this 1D also, so we have to keep 0 ppm. So you can calibrate here as okay, you can give, you can calibrate the 1D also 0 ppm, and you can after that you can go here and you can select here process and calibrate axis, and here because of the two dimensions you have to calibrate for both dimensions, and just click here and you can enter that what are the calibrated value. TMS is 0 ppm, already calibrated here. You can enter calibrate and enter those values here at the center of the P. So you can calibrate like that, and so after that calibration, so you have now there is a internal projections. So you can add projections by adding so you are calibrated. So what I will do now, NLEV 64, okay. Yeah, see actually you can increase the number of levels, thickness means increase. So I increase the number of levels, I think I forgot to increase, and after that, so this option calibrate, and this one is peak picking. So you can click here, you can select and drag, it will pick the peak, for example. So it will pick, and if you save and go back, it will save. And integration also same thing, you can select and drag around the peak, and you can save, and it will save. So after that I want this one to extract as a PDF, then I will go for this plots. So what I will do, I will remove all the whatever the default things, then I will open new one. I want to create a new layout. This is 2D spectrum, 2D. This I dragged. And here actually you have access at the right side, left side and the bottom. So I want to change this axis left to right, because left and top I want to add the projections, and also here you can change the line width and color, and here also font size, different fonts you can use. And if you okay, here those are changed, and you can use grids if you want different axis. You can change the grid as a different colors also, and after that many other options are here, because this Topspin is a high resolution one, 800 dpi. So if you have your system resolution, that display resolution is less than 800, so you will not see this option. For that only one option is, like, you have to hide this toolbar. So right click, hide toolbar, and if you give shift escape, you will get that again. So here I'm seeing some other options. Now I will go to projections. So you can, I will give the top one projection and left another projections, and also I can change the thickness and the color of these projections. So here its thickness is changed. So if you want to increase the intensity of the projection, just you click left click and scroll up, it will increase, and left side also same, left click and scroll up, so it will increase. And if you want to change the colors inside, so you can here you can give positive, I can give blue and little bit thick and okay. And if you want this one is negative different color, you can give dots or anything, so you can change whatever you want. And other than that, in axis, so you can give the limits, so how much you want to extract the spectra. So like here it's minus 1 is there, so I will give 4 ppm 4 ppm to 10 ppm or 4 ppm to 9 ppm I need. So if I give 9, so it will expand like that. So here also I will give here what I will do, I will give from 1 ppm to 4 ppm. So when I enter that, so you can expand like this. If you don't want, so what I will do, I can shift escape. So I will make this all spectra again, and you can select here, you can make all, you can select this expand option and left click and drag how much area you want to expand. So you can expand like this. And if you want to save this as a PDF, so here publish PDF, so you can save this as PDF. And while saving, you can save this as PDF. You can give here PDF, and here you can give Toxi, and you can give the resolution 1200, or you can give different, if you want different resolutions you can give, and okay. So it will show here the drawing contours now, and when it finish, it will be shown PDF is written. Or if you want to save this as an image, so you can save this as image or anything, or you can mail directly, send this email. Otherwise, if you want to expand, just you can expand right by right clicking here, expand, or you can plot limits, you can vary this plot limits and you can expand. So you can save this as PDF. Then what I will do, I will save this as PDF, then same thing. Okay, so when you plot this, you save it as a PDF. So here I have that PDF, so Topspin. So here it's saved, this is a PDF. So I want to edit this PDF, means I want to put assignments on this, and I want to explain what is going on, something. Then I will copy that PDF and I will paste on the PPT. But when you copy paste that PDF, the images look like it's very blur. If you make expand also, it's blur. And another thing is, it has a white background, like you can't see that one, it will cover something. So for that, best option is go to the spectra and right click, copy that spectra, whether this is 1D or 2D, anything, and go to the PPT and paste, see the difference. So just you copy pasted one, it's like it's not blurred and transparent background. You can edit, like you can overlay different things, and you can compare the spectras. So this is another good option. Means instead of converting PDF, you can copy paste in the PPT and you can use for assignments or any commenting purpose, this one. So if you have any doubts regarding this or any suggestions, so please write, so I can explain, I can improve this in the next video. Thank you.